Hi, let us have a quick introduction on Checkstyle configuration file. The entire instruction on how the auditing should be done, what are all modules to be used for the auditing, and what property to be inherited for the modules, everything is controlled from the configuration file. Let us have a quick overview on the configuration file. Configuration file is nothing but an XML file where it can have n number of modules. Almost all the modules comes under the checker. So I can have n number of modules plugged in into the configuration that is going to list what are all the modules to be used to do the auditing on the source code. Here is the example for sunchecks.xml where I do have n number of modules. So before execution, exclusion file filter is one module, Java doc package is one module, and new line at end of file is another module. Like this, we do have n number of modules. I can plug in whatever the module that needs to get executed against the project as a part of the configuration file. And each module can have its own properties. How that particular module should behave while doing the auditing, I'll be controlling with the properties. As such, modules can be categorized into four major categories: file set check, file filter, audit listener. File set check that is going to check the set of files, and the filter module that is going to filter the audit events. After the audit gets over, it's going to give the event. Whether that particular event should be reported or not, it will be done by the filter module. And file filter modules will filter the files whether the check styles should process or not. And audit listener that is going to report the filtered events, and what type of report to be generated, that will be decided by the audit listener. Overall, what's going to happen, I will be having a checker module where it can have n number of modules, and I will be listing all the modules as a part of the configuration. And each and every file that we are going to execute will be splitted into a tree. Tree in the sense, each and every element, that is right from the brackets, variables, method declaration, everything will be splitted as a tree, and the module will be navigating against the tree. So once the file is made like a tree, something similar to this, each and every module will be operating against the independent element available within the tree, and it will be generating the event whether the condition is being met or not. And in the future lecture, we are going to see how to visualize the specific tree and how to identify the module, how to set the property, and what are all the other elements like metadata properties that we can set as a part of the configuration file. Every configuration file will be adhering to the standard provided by the checkstyle that is available as a DTD file. So this is how the checkstyle XML file should be written, and this is going to define how the design of the checkstyle file should look like. This is a quick introduction on how a checkstyle configuration file should be, and in future lecture we are going to have a deeper discussion on how to integrate various modules, how to set the properties, what is checker, tree walker, and how to set the severity, how to customize the messages, how to use filters, and a lot more we are going to see as a part of future lecture.